Good day, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard WestJet Airlines Flight 153 from Calgary to Edmonton. Currently, the weather over here seems to be pretty cold. Got some snow. Boy, do I hate snow. So, let's just hop into the flight deck, close those doors, and make sure the passengers don't get too cold. And let's get the heck out of here, because I'm looking forward to a flight down to Cuba later on. First things first, as usual, we'd go through the cockpit preparation checklist. However, this time I'm going to check off some things I know are already finished. And we'll start off with where we need to be. So that is the pressurization panel. We need to have flight level 160 here. And ATIS information is obtained already. The FMC is programmed. We have to also set up the AFDS. So I think our V2 speeds are 140 for today, and cruise is going to be 160, that's alright. Let's take a quick look here. Yeah, so takeoff is going to be 130, we'll keep 140, 10 knots extra, that's fine. Flight instruments are set, no flags other than the altimeter disagree. Warning enunciations are checked. Set those auto brakes to RTO. And we're pretty much ready to go. Before start checklist, let's make sure we close all those doors. Alright, cabin doors are closed, and let's close those cargo doors as well. Closing, perfect. Let's switch on those seatbelt signs. External power and air are disconnected, make sure those are. And forward fuel aft and forward fuel pumps on. I don't think we have any fuel in the center tank today. We do not, so we're all good. And electronic hydraulic pumps 1 and 2 need to come on. And the anti-collision lights need to come on also. And now we're going to call for pushback and engine start. FS actions. Pushback. And let's get underway. Okay, looks like we got nobody, so we're just gonna have to do this manually. That is with Shift P, the good old Shift P. Parking brake disengaged. Make sure we don't have any chocks. Okay, we should be good now. Let's get those engines running. Flight control switches left and right. Coming off, and make sure we have the engine selected down here. And let us start up engine number 2. And there she goes. The plane just backing up all by itself.
Welcome,
eh?
Welcome aboard Delta Virtual Airlines. Thank you for flying with us today. Sit back, relax, and enjoy your flight.
Okay, that's far enough. Thank you very much. And there goes engine number 1. Make sure the throttle is idle. And here she comes, here she comes, here she comes. 20, and there she goes. That is engine number 1, ladies and gentlemen. Engine number 1. Get a nice gate view here. Today's weather is provided by FSWX. If you guys don't have enough money for Active Sky Next, I highly recommend FSWX for you guys. It is actually a pretty great add-on, and honestly, the weather depiction seems to be pretty realistic. Provided that you combine it with the right cloud textures, that is. And cloud textures and runway textures and airport textures are provided today by Envtex. All my items will be in the description if you want some more details on that. Alright, before taxi checklist, engine generator switches number 1 and numero 2. APU bleed switch off. Pack control switches left and right, coming back to auto. Isolation valves set to auto. Probe heat left and right, coming on. Keeping those probes nice and warm in this cold weather. Boy, do I hate the cold weather. And obviously because it's snowing, we can tell that we're going to need some anti-ice today. APU gen switches off. Engine start selectors are off. Flaps, let us set flaps 5. 3 notches for 5. Auto throttle armed. Flight controls. This is my favorite one right here. Ah, that's right. We don't have flight control checks in the 737-700. It's a little bit of an older plane. Full left, full right, full up, full down, full rudder left, and full rudder right. I think that should suffice for flight control check. Taxi light on, runway turn off lights as needed, not needed at this time. And now we begin our taxi to the runway. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, ready to start our takeoff. Let's just run through the before takeoff checklist. Engine start selectors set to continuous. And landing lights coming right on there. Strobe lights are already on. And traffic mode slash transponder set to TARA. Excellent. And here we go. Pull it right up to 41, make sure it gets stable. There she is, and Toga. Boy, I love to hear those engines roar. AD. 100.
V1.
V1,
rotate. Rotate. V2. Here we go. Oh wow, we gotta fix this view up. And landing gear right on up. Flaps 2, flaps 1. Let's turn on the autopilot and fix up this view. That's gonna be it for the takeoff and climb. So we'll see you guys when we start the descent. Until then, enjoy these beautiful cinematic views. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. We are just about to start our descent. First things first, when we go into the descent checklist, I'm pretty sure autopilot's going to manage to descent. This is going to be nice and easy. We don't have that much to go all the way down to 5,000. Runway elevation is around 2,500, so we're basically pretty close.
We have now commenced our descent into our destination.
So 5,000 is going to be our minimum for today. Now, descent checklist. FMC, the arrival and the approach are set. Flight instruments, nav, altitude, and radios are good. Transition altitude, no need. Wing and engine anti-ice. Right now we're 8 degrees. We have to wait until it gets down to around 0 to negative 10. Recall, check. Auto brake, going to be doing 2. Landing data, so we're going to be doing on the radio altimeter. And we'll do pretty much average 150. And the VR speed is already inputted. Approach briefing is complete, hence because we don't have a co-pilot, so yeah, we don't need that. So actually what I noticed here is that there's no snow. Half an hour the other way, there is. Funny how weather works like that, eh? Anyways, we'll see you back after one more cinematic shot, last one I promise. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Right now we're just decelerating to 190, getting our last two turns done here before we lined up with the runway. So before landing checklist, landing lights on, speed brakes, let's arm those. Actually they're already armed. Seatbelt signs are on, altimeters are set, and engine start selectors, we gotta set those to continuous. I'm gonna do flaps 1. And spoilers up. And we'll keep that nose at 0 here, just on the horizon. We'll control our descent just with speed, put in some trim there because the nose is falling a little bit. And we're right on the localizer. A little bit off to the left, let's fix that up. Decrease our throttle. We're starting to get above the glide slope. And correcting our angle right now. Pull back a bit. Get some more throttle in there, we're falling below. And start to bank left just a bit to align ourselves up. And then we'll decrease a little bit of throttle because we're getting back above. And pull just a little bit up. And we'll take a 5-degree nose up. Correction, that is a 2.5-degree nose up. Typically, you want all final descents or final approaches to be at 2.5 degrees nose up. And then you want the touchdown or flare to be at 5 degrees nose up. That'll give you the optimal landing. So let's just see how that works over here, as we are a little bit above. We are coming a little bit high, but that's fine. 150.
100. 50. 30. 20.
And 10. Now throttle back. And float. We went over 5 degrees. And we didn't cut the throttle early enough.
Thank you for flying with us.
Flaps up. Auto brake off. And let's switch off those landing lights. Switch off those strobe lights. And taxi lights are on. APU start. Engine start selector set to off. Probe heat left and right. Coming right off. Wing and engine GTIs are off. Auto brakes are off. Speed brakes are down, flaps are up, and transponder mode will set that to standby. Excellent, not a bad flight if I do say so myself. Though she needs quite a little bit of throttle to get her moving on the ground, something I've noticed. Another thing, I wasn't really used to the low V speeds, or the low VREF speeds for this plane. 737-700 is quite a bit smaller than the 737-800. Therefore the speed requirements are lower, so I was flying with 140, which is a typical landing speed on the 737-800. No matter though, I think it still turned out alright. We were off to the left on the center line, and we did come in, we did float, but we got the plane down on the ground, and that's really all that matters, I think. From the passenger's point of view, at least. Maybe not maintenance crews. Anyways, I'll stop blabbering and get this plane pulled up. And we'll pause the flight and we'll see if chase plane replays will work with us today. We'll let it roll this way a bit and then just yank her to the right like that. And just a little bit more, and stop right there. Set the parking brake, pause the flight. And let's view that replay. And that is chase plane replay for you, ladies and gentlemen. Well, sadly this flight ended, had to end like this. I apologize for that, ladies and gentlemen, but I thank you for joining me on this beautiful WestJet flight from Calgary to Edmonton, and hope you guys join me again for the next one. I'll see you later. Fly safe.